welcome! My name is Hiro, and this is my Let's Play series of Europa Universalis IV, where we are playing as... well, as Hosokawa, trying to form Japan. And we are, of course, playing in the new Mandate of Heaven expansion. I haven't been that thorough in explaining this expansion in the last video, but I will be putting out another video, hopefully one of the next few days, where I will explain in more detail what is in the expansion and the accompanying update, the free update for Europa Universalis. So if you want to learn more about that, I will be posting a video one of the next few days. But for now, let's just get back into the action here. So we are in a war with the Amago and the Kono here, trying to expand our little, well, shogunate here. Not shogunate, our little daimy. What is it called? A daimyate? Ooh, oh, another thing. Ah, I forgot that. So we can now change things for our... That's one of the things that's down here. We need areas, and we need what's it called? States and territories. Okay, so now in each of your states, you can have your own laws. As you can see here, this state is having an income of 0.65 and there's a maintenance of 0.1. And we can add certain edicts. Edicts cost increased state maintenance, but they give certain bonuses. So we could have increased institution spread, we could have autonomy chains, local defensiveness. So basically, if we enabled one of these, would gain would just cost us 0.2 ducats a month. So it might be, once we are making some money, it might make sense to, for example, promote military recruitment and get some extra manpower out of this. And we can do that in anything that is currently a state. And as you can see here, we're actually earning quite a bit of money from all these. This one... what is this? Sure law. Oh, we can... we can't do that on... requires feudal sure law from Age of Discovery. Oh, it's probably something we have to add here. Oh! Yeah, so... then we can get feudal sure law if we give unrest -5. And do we then have to... yeah, I guess we then have to enact it in here. Interesting. And apparently we can have one edict. So we could get extra masonry strength, we could get trade power, manpower, unrest, development cost, defensiveness. So this is just a little bit of extra customization that you can have in this expansion. Anyway, let's get back to sieging. I could probably have been seeking while I was talking about that. Oh, we're losing a lot of money right now. That is not nice. That's just for being over force limit, I think. Oh, and of course we're now paying into... no, that's not a lot. Well, I guess we're just gonna have to take up some loans, because we need these people. We can get rid of the extra men as soon as... it's just over force limit. As soon as we take this, we can get rid of those people that are over the force limit. Because we don't need it for this... stability of money. This is two loans. We'll just... bye-bye money. That's so expensive. So many loans. Hopefully it won't come back to bite us. We can always just declare bankruptcy, which is also a new thing you can do. It's not a nice thing to do, but you can do it if you need. Oh, come on now. 29%. Which is the maximum, because it was the only level 3 fort on the whole map. Yeah. Come on now. At least give us like a... If we had some artillery, we could try to break through the walls, but... Merchant didn't gain 10 influence. Do we want to do anything with these guys? No, not, none of them has enough influence. let's check out the estate map. None of them have any provinces either. I'm not going to worry about that right now. Okay, so... We take out 3 guys. You get done. Get away. Which means that we are now only losing 0.57. And then we sail you down here. Which means that you don't have to stay home at war. You can now go and make us a little bit of extra money, hopefully. And we don't even need to have all of these guys here, so let's just leave 4. And save a little bit on manpower. Do we want to go for this just? Let's just do it. I do like prestige and I do like admin power, so I guess it's not the worst thing in the world. I think I'm just gonna call one of these guys home. Just gonna call this guy home. Was that like instantaneous? I'm just gonna go down in speed. If I send him to do this, he'll go there. Okay, he does have to return. So if I do this. Alright. Yeah. Let's just send him out again. Why do I have to close this to it, make it happen? Why is he not doing it? Okay, there he goes. This is getting to be a long war. What else has happened? You have taken over that province. Otherwise, I don't see much change. What about you? Did you take over a province? You definitely had a claim on this. One of our personal domains under our rulership still owes us outstanding taxes to the tune of 1,000 cocoa of rice. Through communications with our tax collectors, the debtor has argued that his domain is overvalued and that he cannot afford to pay the taxes. We could forgive all or part of the debt, but we could use the money. So we can get it all and lose 25 admin points. We can get some of it and still lose 25 admin points, or we can lose prestige. So if we're gonna lose admin points no matter what, might as well get the money. We're gonna lose some prestige, but if I can pay some loans, that's honestly better. How is our prestige gain anyway? We're actually losing prestige. Birth and I would love it to pause on these. Birth and privilege. The spread of new Confucianism ideas in our society has led to a number of men of humble origins rising to positions of intellectual influence. One of the more prominent scholars of this age is himself the son of a Ronin, and along with the other Confucian scholars, he is intent on making learning some widely available through public lectures and books written in simple language. In many ways, this is a challenge to the old social order where learning was a privilege reserved for the families of the right lineages. So we can support it and get cheaper advisors and go more open. Or we can... Let's just go more open. I want to be open. I'm just very open. Okay, so let's get our diplomat back. Let's get some money as well. It is gonna cost us... It's gonna cost us that if we do directly with you as well. So this is 21. This is 20. Okay, so no matter what we do, it's gonna cost the same. So might as well get his money. And then you. We want you. Oh, just take the maximum there. Take that as well. Call it all. Go to like half. Pay all loans. Let's just stay about half maintenance here. And then of course stop paying for the fort. Okay, so we just expanded quite a lot. So this is one. This is another, and this is a third. But at least we have a full state now. Do you want to do anything here? No, we really don't, but we do trade. One thing we can do now is add this as a state to some of this. So I would probably prefer to get military technology. So let's add it as a Bushi. Although it is really screaming that it wants to be a clergy. You're gonna be a clergy and you're gonna be a Bushi. Which means that both of you. Now, do we want to call diets though? We do have enough here that we can probably just, let's get a general. I should probably have done that. And let's get a, that would be 70, no. So let's just get the 100 points. And here we want a, let's just do this and get the 100 points. Do we want to add something to the merchant guild as well? Maybe. This would take them to a lot. I'd rather add this, wait, and then... Which has more trade power? This one has more trade power. We're just gonna make you a merchant guild. And then we can take some points from them as well. And we're probably gonna grant you a minister, right? And then take some points. Brilliant. And we actually, oh, we lost a little bit of income off that. Not a lot, though. So let's see if we can buy some ships. We can buy a single bark. Let's just do that. 350. Let's actually just do it like this. Oh, and we apparently lost a couple rivals. So we can now add Oshi. Let's just do that. And Ishiki. That makes sense. Let's just make sure. Who are you allied with? You are allied with this guy who we are already... We're already rivals with this guy, right? Are we not? I'm rivaled with... That guy. And I'm rivaled with Ochi. So I'm not rivaled with you. I should probably be rivaled with you. Although I'd rather be rivaled with you. So you have, I think you had a bunch of allies. Yeah, and you only have one. So I'd rather be allied or rivaled with you, because you can only call in one guy. So you can call in him, but he still has a lot smaller army than I do. Especially if we get... No, we didn't get any more force limit out of that. So I am kind of thinking now whether we should do a humiliate, maybe against this guy up here. So if I did a humiliate rival, you would call in a bunch of people. I don't want that. So I can call you in by promising your territory. But I'm pretty sure that you will. I could give you one province here. And then take the rest for myself. Or I could just promise your province and not give it to you. But I think I could probably win that war on my own. Let me just... Let's just wait a little bit. At least until we have caught these. Let's get this guy back. You would want to be allied again now. You are rivaled with that guy and with Shiba and with Yamana. Let's just see if we can get him to be a rival again. Not a rival, our ally again. Call him back. Losing face. Oh, that's not good. But I don't want to lose stability. So I guess we're losing face. Want to be an ally again? Yes. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. I'm just going to force it to improve with this guy. Let's actually... Let's do a... claim on this guy just to save a little bit of money. It is not a lot of development, but a little bit is it's also good. So many things that loses prestige for me. Well, I'm trying to get prestige to get admin points, so I'm not gonna pay admin points to get prestige. That doesn't seem like it makes sense. How are we doing on money? Still bad. I should have chosen him as a rival, then we could have gone to war with this guy, humiliated him out of the war. You, by the way, should go here. Actually, go here so we are ready to take that harbor. So you're claiming a bunch of stuff. Go you. Course are finishing. Ship is finishing. I'm interested to see if we'll get more manpower, more force limit out of it. I don't think we will though. We are at 4.76. We can now get, let's just wait with diplomacy, but I will take military as soon as I can. Diplomacy, might as well wait for see if we can get that 5% bonus. So we should see the Renaissance start anytime soon, which of course will take a while to get here. I'm thinking... I'm thinking about trying for... I'm thinking about trying for exploration as the first idea group, to see if we can spawn that idea at us. Or that institution at us. I don't know. It might be better to go for something that we can use to actually take over Japan, but... Okay, we have enough now so we can fabricate a claim here on you. Take that back and probably build Spinalberg on you. So you still only have that one ally. I'm really tempted. He is right there though, so it would be basically a matter of generals, because he would be able to join almost instantly. We have a 3-3-1. And we have a siege general for afterwards. So he has a level 1 fort. Level 1 fort. Could I just call you home? I could call you in for a fee or for land. How far am I away from being able to call you in for a favor? 5 years. Okay. I don't really want to wait 5 years. I also don't want to give him any land. I'm also not sure if I actually need him. Oh, this is a 50% less aggressive expansion for using those. That is interesting. I like the idea of expanding fast, but on the other hand, I don't want to make everyone too mad at me too soon. Let's see, let's add the... I remember now what's in this, the coalition map mode. think I'm gonna wait until I have some more claims on this guy at least. I'm gonna be a little bit slow about this. So let's just have you improve with allies. Actually, have you produce... yes, just do it with allies. And we're just gonna wait a little bit. I don't want him to be friends with anyone else. He has a royal marriage with the Shogun. Let's just get this now. No reason to take this while we're not at war, I guess. So this would be... I would be able to take this whole state in that war. It would be glorious. What is my other option? I could go to war with this guy. I would be at war with... those guys, this guy. Ooh, you have actually taken over our province. Interesting. What did you? Oh, you started with that. Okay. Of course, if I went to war with you, everyone would be against me. So I can't really take this war, I think. It's too much. And these guys also have too many friends. So this is really the only option. Well, what about this? Toki and Oshiku. Okay, so not him either. What about you? Shimatsu and Yamana. I think our only option is to attack him right now. And I kind of want to do it while that's an option. But it is attacking into hills. And he has as many people. Yeah, I'm still leaning towards waiting for something to aid me. Either him going to war or actually being able to call him in without giving him territory. Peasant getting uppity, so he can get some. Let's lose legitimacy. Apparently we don't need that. And now they're mad at me. But I guess that's just okay. Yeah, and Renaissance came along, so now we can enjoy some tech penalty. Let's just get this while there's 5% discount on it. Oh, so we lost a rival. Which means I can take you. Which means now the war actually suddenly seems even better now. Because we can humiliate you. Which would be awesome. So again, if we look at this. I would probably prefer to take this from you. Well, I could take this and this. Yeah, let's just get this. At least that decision maybe needs to go up again. Anyway, I think I'm gonna take a break here and we'll see about that war next time, I think. Anyway, hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, consider the like button, subscribing. Hope to see you next time, and until then, have a good day.